DDP, DDU, FOB, EXW. If you see these acronyms and think, what the f- does it all mean? This video is going to be for you. When you first start Amazon, you need to understand how to get your products from a factory in China all the way into your customers' hands. That's going to take you working with your factory, freight forwarders, maybe some 3PLs, aka third-party logistic warehouses, Amazon's preferred partner carriers, aka UPS, and a load more. On top of that, you need to understand HS codes and how much duties and tariffs you should be paying on your imports. Something that I covered in this video. It sounds like a lot to learn, doesn't it? That's because it is. But don't fret, that is why I'm here. I'm going to walk you through the process step by step so you leave this video fully prepared to send your products into Amazon and start making some of that sweet, sweet cash money. So first, let's say you found your product, negotiated with your supplier, you've calculated your duties using my previous video, I hope, and you are ready to place your order. The supplier will likely have quoted you two rates, EXW and FOB. FOB means free on board. That means your supplier will produce the products, pack them, and get them to the port and cover any export fees to get them onto the ship or aeroplane, if you're feeling fancy. EXW means Ex Works. That means the supplier just produces and packs the products. It's then down to you and your freight forwarder to collect the goods, export them, and get them loaded onto the ship or plane. You will find generally the EXW price is lower than the FOB price because of the exporting fees. So in the end, it usually kind of balances out. So it doesn't matter too much which one you go for, but FOB is probably the most common. So we're going to go with that. Now you need to find a freight forwarder. So this is the company that handles getting your products from point A to point B. For example, from China to an Amazon warehouse or to your 3PL. Stick around actually, because in a few minutes, I'll let you know one that we have had success with and we can give you guys a link. So shipping wise, your forwarder is gonna have a few options. The most common being DDP and DDU on an LCL, which is a less than container load basis. This is acronym city over here. DDP means delivery duties paid. This means that the forwarder will handle everything, you pay them a set fee, and you are good to go. So DDP can be great, sometimes even a little too good to be true. The reason for that is that it's fairly common for DDP importers to underdeclare your product cost, leading to lower duties and tariffs paid. In all honesty, it's pretty unlikely that you're ever gonna get caught for this. However, if you do, you are the importer of record and you are the one who is legally responsible. So if you're inspected and have been found to be underpaying, you could be in for a nasty backdated fine from the US Customs. Further to that, if, like us, you want to sell your business within a couple of years, acquisition teams will generally want to see your importing invoices for the previous couple of years. So if they see that you've obviously been under declaring, they may knock money off their offer or even worse than that, put out of the deal completely. However, as you now know how to calculate your duties owed, and in a minute, I'll be able to show you how to calculate the cubic meters of your units being shipped as well. You can run the math and you can check to see if the quotes add up. In summary, a general rule of thumb to go by with DDP is if it seems too good to be true, it probably is. DDU means delivery duties, you probably guessed it, unpaid. This means that the forwarder will handle everything for you still. You'll pay them upfront for the shipping and they'll then cover your duties and tariffs and invoice you retrospectively for the costs. If you ship by this method, you can still obviously check that the math works out in terms of the shipping costs and the duties, and you're ensuring that you are paying the exact correct duties because you are going to see an invoice retrospectively. As I mentioned earlier, we do have a great forwarder that we work with. They're called Forwarder One. We've got a link down below. If you use that, we do get a couple of beers, I'll be honest, but you know, hopefully this video is of use to you and you don't begrudge us a couple of free beers. They're great because you can actually track your shipment online as well, so super easy and convenient. You will find that a lot of factories do often offer shipping terms as well. Just be aware, it's most likely gonna be on a DDP basis. What they generally do is have shipping partners. They're obviously passing the jobs onto their friends and saying that it is them doing the shipping. So what information do you need to get a quote? You're gonna need the following. Your HTS code, your value per master carton, the length, width, and height of, height? height of each master carton, the weight per master carton, the number of master cartons in the shipment, and the Amazon FBA warehouse address or your 3PL. So if you haven't sent a product before, like your Amazon fulfillment center will be given to you when you make the actual shipping plan. Obviously, as some of you won't have had that yet, what we recommend is Google some West Coast based fulfillment centers. For example, ONTA, I'll flash up the address for that here. Now you can get quotes for air freight, Matson Express Lane and regular sea shipping. We strongly advise getting quotes when you're in product research phase. You really don't want to do a load of work, get down the road with a product idea, and then realize that the shipping makes it impossible. So definitely do this from the start, make it a habit with any products that look good. With the master carton information, you can also calculate your cubic meters per carton. Now, as I said earlier, you'd often get quoted by freight forwarders on a cubic meter basis. So knowing this math will stop you getting misquoted. How we do this is we multiply the master carton's length times width times its height and divide it by 1 million. For example, 62 centimeters times 40 centimeters times 35 centimeters divided by 1 million equals 0.086 cubic meters per carton. Now, a 40 foot HQ container has around 70 cubic meters of space, and I don't usually do public math, but I believe you could fit around 814 master cartons onto it. Some products can actually fit like 100 units in a carton. So as you can imagine, when you get up to full container loads, economies of scale can really come into play and your shipping costs can really drop down. So you've got a product, you've got a shipping quote you're happy with, and your first run of units have been produced and you're ready to ship. Now you're gonna send them straight into Amazon. So now you need to know how to make your first shipping plan. Subscribe to the channel, check out my next video, and you can see how it's done.